All right. Here's a question I really like. What makes you mad or irritated? The word no. Have you ever had a role model, and who was it?
I've had lots of role models.
My role model as a singer was always Jeff Buckley. My other role model as a singer was Chris Cornell. But in the end, I have so many people that I listen to, and there are so many great singers and songwriters out there. And some of the best singers don't have the most beautiful voices. I love Tom Waits, and I love Nick Cave. And I take little bits and pieces from the people that I watch and try to put it into what I do.
You mentioned that you like the Vampire Chronicles of Anne Rice. Have you read the new Vampire Chronicles, and did you like it? What's your favorite character?
I started it. It's called Prince Lestat. I started it, and I have to say I didn't get very far. I don't feel like it has the power that the other stories have. And it seemed to get a little confused. For me, the best Anne Rice book is Queen of the Damned. I always loved that book. One, because Lestat's already a rock star. Two, because it deals a lot with the role of women in religion and women in power. And because Akasha's a badass. What do my eye tattoos mean? I always like the idea of perspective. My mother always taught me there are two sides to every story, and everybody has their own point of view, and that was sort of my idea. And then I got my last one, which is a face with an eye closing. I said, sometimes you just have to close your eyes. Sometimes you literally have to close yourself off and say, I'm not gonna take part in this. What supernatural ability would you like to possess? Everybody wants to fly. I want to fly. Would you like to play in a movie?
Yes.
What song could be your life hymn? Ooh. I have three theme songs, and they all have different reasons. One theme song is a song called Stupidity Tries by a guy named Elliot Smith. It's because I like the idea of a proud loser, and I listen to that when I feel like a loser. When you feel like you've made some big mistakes and you just have to get through it, I put that on. The end to that song is great. Mm-hmm. My two other theme songs are sort of like, you know, when you feel ugly and fat and you want to make yourself feel sexy and attractive when you look in the mirror, I put these songs on. And one is Hoochie Coochie Man by Muddy Waters. And the other one is Sympathy for the Devil by the Rolling Stones. And I put those on and I am ready to go. Try to imagine you are a woman. What character would you like to play on stage? Oh, there's so many. There's so many good ones. Mrs. Lovett and Sweeney Todd. Carla or Claudia in Nine. Lola in Damn Yankees.
Let's leave it at that. Those are good ones. What did you want to be when you were a child? I wanted to work for Disney, and I wanted to draw and make animation movies. And then, I think there was a time I wanted to have a restaurant when I was a kid. I still think that'd be fun. That'd be crazy stress, but I think that'd be fun. And then, when I was 12, I saw Les Miserables for the first time, and Jesus Christ Superstar for the first time. And I knew from that moment on that's what I was going to do. Last summer, you attended the Guns N' Roses concert. Can you compare the emotions and impressions of being on stage and not being in front of and being in front of the stage? I love seeing live music. I always did, and I was able to go when I was growing up to a lot of like punk rock concerts in little tiny clubs, and I just loved the way a performer can sort of grab a crowd like, you are going to listen to me right now. And I have used that for my career as well, and make sure that when I go on stage, I'm giving everything I can possibly give. And I got the Guns N' Roses album, Appetite for Destruction, when I was 11, I think. And it changed me. I remember hearing it and thinking, oh my God, this is strong stuff. I have the power to frighten my parents and to scare my teachers and to feel like a badass. And I want to do that. And so watching them, and they, you know, they played such a big role in me wanting to learn to play the guitar. And so going and seeing them up close on a big stage was amazing. And of course, after, you know, when the band broke up, nobody thought we were ever going to see them again. And then I saw Axl in 2006 when he had the sort of new Guns N' Roses, which wasn't Guns N' Roses, it was just a bunch of guys with Axl Rose. And I remember seeing that concert going, that's really great. It wasn't Guns N' Roses, but it was really great. And then going to see them this time was fantastic. A friend of mine, Stephanie Reese, with whom I did The Hunchback in Berlin, her sister is the keyboard player for Guns N' Roses now. And so going and watching them and saying, I know someone in the band, was really fucking cool. Do you usually help your kids with their homework? Yes, that's what I was just doing. Unfortunately, my kids are getting so smart that I can't help them anymore. I can just sort of sit there and say, I hope you know what you're doing, because I don't. What was your most gratifying experience in life? Having kids, probably. And seeing that my kids have turned out as well as they have. And I give my wife all the credit for that, because she has done so much more than I have. But watching the kids grow up and turn into the people that they are now is just fantastic. Have kids, they're fun. Do your kids have your songs in their playlists?
No.
No, they don't. There was a time when my son would listen to it every now and then, but no. They think I'm embarrassing, and that's okay. I'm a dad, and dads should be embarrassing. What music do your kids like? My son has turned into a huge Guns N' Roses fan. Like, he listens to it every day. My daughter likes Lana Del Rey. She likes Katy Perry. She likes Ed Sheeran. And she likes Enya. Let's do three more.
Okay.
The lyrics for the song The Emperor are much like the story of King Enkel in the Vampire Chronicles of Anne Rice. Is it a kind of allusion to the storyline?
No.
But I like that someone thought that.
No, the idea of the Emperor is when you... was that moment of realizing how many mistakes you've made and how big they were. And that moment of being frozen and saying, I cannot move because the world is too heavy. If you had a time machine, would you want to go to the past and change something in your life?
Whoosh.
Would I want to change anything? I don't think there's a point to that, because I'd probably end up making the same mistake again anyway. And I've had a pretty good life. I've made some big mistakes, but they make me who I am. So, take your mistakes and own them and use them. Don't erase them.
Last one. Let's see if we can get a good one.
Tell us the last book you read and the last good movie you've seen. The last book I read was a book called The Woman in the Window. I won't remember the author's name. The Woman in the Window, it's relatively new. It's sort of an homage to Alfred Hitchcock. It's sort of a murder thriller kind of book about agoraphobia, which is the fear of open spaces, the fear of going outside. It was really good. Really good. Woman in the Window. Go and read it. The last good movie I saw, The Shape of Water. I saw The Shape of Water, and that was a fantastic movie. It was a simple love story told in a way that you would never expect to see it. But the basic idea is that love is love is love is love is love is love, and it doesn't matter who the person is that you love or what... or who you love, as long as you love.
Yeah.
And that's the way we're gonna end it.